The first ever BioBlitz in BC has commenced in the Peace River Valley. About 30 scientists and many volunteers are currently on a mission exploring the area for research.
To sample all sorts of biological diversity, plants and insects in particular, but other groups as well. We'll be looking at birds a little bit and mammals and even fossils.
The BioBlitz, which consists of scientists from the Biological Survey of Canada, the Royal BC Museum, and federal and provincial governments, started on Monday and they will continue researching until Friday. Langor says the excursion is a way to gain more knowledge about what exists in the area.
We'll be gathering a lot of information about the diversity in this area, gathering specimens, which many will be deposited in collections across the country, and most importantly, we'll have data about the identification of those specimens and their distribution along the river.
Part of the scientists' area of study includes the location that will be flooded by Site C. Langor says the BioBlitz wasn't necessarily planned to do research before work on the dam starts, but because little information about the area exists.
Regardless of whether a dam's going in or not, this is an area of British Columbia that's actually pretty poorly known for its fauna and flora. Some work that's been done recently has highlighted a couple of plant species and one insect species that appear to be relatively rare, and they're occurring in this area.
After a week of getting their hands dirty, Langor says the scientists will go back to their respective labs and start the identification process, which could take years to complete.
For many plants, they're relatively easily identified. For many insect groups, however, it takes some time.
Langor hopes to do future research in the Peace River Valley and says with only a week to collect data, they're only scratching the surface.
We really hope is to turn this week-long BioBlitz into perhaps a longer-term biological survey over the course of the next few years, where there'll be many opportunities for other people to go back and continue the sampling there.
Carissa Wilson, CJDC TV News, Fort St. John.